Hello everybody. Yes, it's me, Foxy, and welcome to this special video. And yes, this video you may find is slightly unusual, but it may be well worth the watch. This video is reviewing and giving some comments on a little business that is just a likeable enchanted delight, I must say. This business I'm referring to is, if I may be repeating once again, the likeable enchanted delight through intent interest. But this business, if I may be giving a reviewing speech on it, never mind. Sorry, Daphne. I'll be with you later. That was my cat meowing at my door. Cheeky girl. But she's absolutely lovely, don't worry. As we all love our Daphne. But getting off of Daphne, but to the business I'm doing this reviewing speech about. This business, it's quite like a fashionable boutique business. But it's not just a fashionable ladies' boutique. It's also got fashionable men's clothes from, according to one of their workers, the two prominent ones, who I've generally seen, never said which era the clothes were from. But one of the workers said they were from the 1960s, the men's clothes. And they're fairly exclusive clothes. So, saying that they're exclusive clothes gives a few clues as to what the business is. Because I can remember, I was recommending this because this business, this fashionable ladies' boutique and fashionable men's clothes and other sort of stuff and business. Well, it's fashionable business. It also sells some very nice cushions, and I'm sitting on my armchair here. I'm sitting behind one of the cushions, which I have placed under my armchair, which is this, which I bought from the shop. To many people, a shop is probably just a shop. But this is not just a shop, it's a really exciting little business. It's a business where you just get the finest approach of hospitality, and oh my goodness, you would meet there some two wonderful ladies, generally two wonderful ladies. But we're getting to the ladies later. It has staff you would just feel enormously thankful for. Even if it's many months since you've last been to the shop, you just cannot help but feel thankful for the staff, even if you've not seen them for many months. And I showed you the cushion I bought from there. It's not only a ladies' boutique, as I said to you before, but it sells men's clothes, also sells men and women's socks, and sells trouser belts, and they also sell some fashionable cushions. Very fashionable cushions, I must say, showing you one of them just a few short minutes ago or so, just now. It's a fine business. But giving you the name of the business, some of you may already know this, or may have already heard of it, but this business is the Covet business. And Covet, it's comprised of three distinct little shops. One of their shops, the Covet shops, one of them is located in Church Road in Hove, which is really not too far from where I live, and it's fairly easy for me to walk there whenever I need to buy something from there, at times whenever the time has arose for me to get something from there. And they have another one on Ship Street in Brighton, in the Brighton city centre. And finally, their third shop is located in the Lewis High Street in the ancient little town of Lewis in East Sussex. So, but it's many people will probably just think, oh, they're just shops. But no, the way I see it is a fine business of charmingly kind hospitality and friendliness, and sells just thing, not only things that are fashionable, but heritage-like things oneself can fervently appreciate for decades, even years, decades to come. Really, it sells things, once you've bought it, just something one could just really, really appreciate in having, since they're generally not sold all that much in other ordinary shops and all that. You know. That's why. And also the staff. Oh, the staff are marvellous. You would just be thankful for them, as said to you before. But generally, getting to the staff of the COVID shop, there may be some funny things said, and some things you may, which may give some people ordinary thoughts to. Generally, the staff in the COVID shop in Hove, which is nearest to me, it's generally two ladies working there on different days, but sometimes they have a swap over or a switch of other staff from the other COVID shops located in either Brighton or Lewis. Sometimes they have a switch of the COVID staff from either the COVID shop in Brighton or the COVID shop in Lewis, just to say. But generally, two ladies work there in the Hove one nearest to me in COVID. A very nice, when I first went in, because I first went into the COVID shop in April, in the middle of April of 20, well, almost late April, but the middle of April. Of 2021. I remembered going in. I think one person had came in and bought something. And I came in to see what there was to buy. Having seen it before, and I thought, I really should have gone there before. But you know something, when it's opened up again, I'm going to go. And so therefore, I went, and all that. And when I went in, I took a little look around to see what was in the COVID shop. The lady who was working in the COVID shop, when I walked in, she was like, hi. And I said fairly quietly, I was like, oh, hello. I was like, oh, hello. And then I began to observing around the shop. Whilst I was observing around the lovely little shop, when wandering around it, I saw this little cushion, the one I showed you, and I was like, this looks very nice. I love the little bumblebee print on it. And then I turned towards the lady, speaking up a bit. I said, is this cushion for sale? And she was like, yes, yes, it is. So then I picked up the cushion and then brought it over to the counter. And I was like, and please name your price for the cushion. The way I said it, oh my goodness. Please name your price, please, for the cushion. And the lady was like, that would be about £40, please. It was an expensive cushion. I mean, it wouldn't surprise me for it being as expensive as about No, it was £60, sorry, not 40, 60. So, incredibly expensive cushion, but it was fairly old and old-fashioned, with old-fashioned-like print. But it wouldn't surprise me, really, because it has old-fashioned print on the cushion, and also it's a cushion you don't generally find in ordinary shops. So that's why it cost me quite a lot. And also because it's quite exclusive, so that's why it's more expensive, because of how exclusive it is and fairly rare, and how heritage-like it is, so very old and all that. So I paid for it, and then I took it back home with me and placed it on the armchair, and I was like, this is going to be very nice on my armchair. A very nice little cushion on my armchair. And then I visited the Covid shop again about nearly a couple of months later. It was the next day after I was vaccinated against Covid. I went to the Covid shop the next day, but probably wasn't the best time to have gone, really, because I was undergoing side effects from the vaccine. I went in, I just walked in and I was looking around, and then I saw another lady, but this time it was a different lady. A different lady to the one I saw in April. I just looked away, and then I just looked, but was quite lacking with total concentration. And I was like, oh, hello. And she's like, hello. We just said some very swift hellos. And then I was just looking around to see what... But in a total lacking of concentration, I could hardly decide what I wanted to purchase from the Covid shop. So I picked up about two pairs of socks. They were considerably cheaper than the cushion. And then I brought them over to the counter. And and then I saw the lady. This time I saw her fairly close up. Here comes some funnier bits. But it's probably not so funny this part, but it will get funnier. I just have to spoil it because for the saying the funnier part, because you may find it very funny if I give the reveal. And so then, once put it to the counter, the lady asked me to pay the full price, which I always do when I buy things from the shop, as anyone would do when they purchase things they want to from the shop, from any shop in general. And I just looked in my wallet, I took out a cash note and put it on the counter, and it's like, I'm sorry, I've really not got enough change to give you. And I was like, never mind, I'll do the alternative, which was the card payment. And he said, but I'm quite keen on cash. I was like, of course I am, but doctor, what? I said, I'm quite keen on the occasional payments of cash too, as I do both. But not to worry, we've still got a little bit of time yet to keep using cash payments. But the lady was not entirely sure. But in reality, because obviously she had a different opinion to myself. She was like, well, hopefully. And then I saw her putting in the price for me to pay on the pen on the card machine. And then I was looking fairly directly at her. I was like, I know. And I was like, I know. And then I ended up, and then I ended up saying a bit louder, saying, but it's certainly nice seeing you looking lovely today. Hey. And then she just looked at me and pulled a sad-looking smile, a fairly sad-looking smile, and she was like, Oh, thank you. She's like, oh, thank you, thank you. That's what she said to me. But when I said that she was looking lovely, it just shot out of my mind. I was so taken by what this lady looked like. I was very taken by what she looked like when I said she was looking lovely. But, you know, she was... I would say she was... You know, she's just extremely good-looking, very pretty for a little old lady. I mean, she looked quite old, but despite that, despite being all wrinkly and a little bit saggy around the neck, and all wrinkled around the face, she was just surprisingly pretty for a little old lady. No, really, she is. Well, she's still alive. For a fact, she's still very much alive, but really surprisingly pretty for a little old lady. I would say that. And I ended up having a little crush on her. I was, but I completely controlled myself, but I wanted to go further after saying that. I was about to ask her, oh, where are you going to be tomorrow night, hmm? Or would you like to make out? I did not ask those, but I thought about asking it to her, but I completely controlled myself and did not go any further after saying she looked lovely. I did not go any further after that. And so I subsequently made the payment and could not help but really say goodbye to her. I was like, well, goodbye. I said, well, see you another time. Goodbye. And then I gave her a little wave, and then I respectfully walked out of the shop. And then I was just like, oh. When I was walking out, I was like, goodness, isn't this lady pretty? I said, isn't this lady pretty? She may look older than the other lady I've seen, but goodness, is she pretty? Why? And then I went in the third time I went into COVID, I saw the lady again, who I saw back in June. And, well, I had the same jacket on and the same hat. And then she looked at me and I looked towards... This time I was not undergoing side effects. And I was more fully functional this time and more alert with concentration. And then she said to me, hi! And she was smiling, really, like, smiling at me when she saw me. I was like, oh, hello! I said, and before I was going to purchase... I don't know whether I did purchase anything or if I just browsed in that time. And I was like, it's nice to... And then she asked how I was. She really remembered me when I saw her. I said, all is okay, and it's really nice seeing you looking lovely today, as well as looking very pretty. And she was like, oh, thank you. And then she said, you're very kind, aren't you? In which I was thankful for when she complimented me. And then I went, the fourth time I went in, it was again in July, and I saw the lady I saw back in August. And she recognised what I looked like. Surprisingly enough, she still did. I had the same hat on, but I was not wearing a jacket because it was such a hot day that day when I saw her in July, but not in April. It was incredibly cold when I saw her the first time I ever saw her. And she recognised me and said, no, it's nice seeing you. He said, no, you're looking very smart and it's nice seeing you. I was like, oh, thank you very much. When she complimented me over what I looked like, I said, it's nice seeing you. I said, well, it's been quite a while since I last saw you. And I said, but it's too hot to wear the jacket, I'm afraid. And she said, I'm not surprised. I said, but I was in here before, some time before today. And she said, oh, really? I said, but were you? And I was like, oh, yes, I was here before today. Hey, but you were not in. I said, a different lady was in when you were there. She said, oh, yes, I know her. That was very nice. I said, well, sadly, we're not full-time workers here, but I know who you're referring to. and I described to her what she... Well, I didn't really, because I didn't want to go too far. I didn't describe what she looked like until sometime later to her. I think it was a browse at that point. And then I was in a couple of days later, and I saw the pretty old lady. Well, she's blonde, just to say. Well, personally, I think she dyes her hair blonde, because I did see a prominent patch of grey in the centre part of her hair, despite the blonde being blonde elsewhere. And then I saw her again about a couple of days later, and I was in to purchase a belt. It was still quite a hot day, but it was cooler compared to the to 2 days prior. And, but she was in nothing but a sleeveless dress. I was like, well, I hope you're not going to be slightly chilly with no sleeves on your dress. She was like, it's still very warm. I remember her saying it. And she said, but she recognised what I looked like still. I mean, I had a jacket, but it was a sleeveless jacket and a long sleeve shirt, but my sleeves were partly rolled up, but not completely rolled up. But the 2 days prior, I was in short sleeves, but no shorts. And she said, sometime I go swimming in the sea. And I was like, do you really? And she said, oh yes. I said, do you swim in the sea? I was like, no. No, I'll express it better. I was like, oh no, I do not go swimming in the sea in the slightest, no. And she said, oh, do you not? I said, it's far too cold for me to go. And she said, no, I even swim in the sea, even on a cooler day in the British summers, is what the older lady said. I said, I could not do that. I was like, no, it's far too cold for me to swim in the sea. Even in the British summer, it's much too cold, especially as I feel the cold more. And she said, oh, do you not like swimming in the sea? The lady asked, and I was like, nope, not, I'm afraid not. I was like, the British summers are not warm enough for me to swim in the sea, even in a British heat wave. And she's like, oh. And then she was looking, and so then I paid for the belt, which I paid for. And then after I paid for the belt, I said, but what you could say is, I said, despite the fact that I feel the cold more and all that and do not swim in the English sea, then I said, I am nonetheless still fortunate to have a full head of hair for a man. I mean, because I wasn't wearing my hat. But then the lady looked at me, and then she looked rather surprised after what I said, and she said, looking at me and looking, she looked at my face and my figure, and she said, but you're just a boy, aren't you? I would expect you to have a full head of hair. She thought I was younger than 18 when she saw what I looked like. I was like, actually, I'm a grown man. And she's like, oh, okay. I said, well, have a nice evening. And I said, thank you, and you too. And then before I could go, I couldn't go without giving her a compliment. And I said, but it's nice seeing you looking lovely today. And she's like, oh, it's very kind of you, and thank you, is what she said. And then we both waved to it, and then I left. Although I did briefly see her on the last Sunday of July, but I didn't go into Covent, but she saw me out the window from it, and we both waved to each other. I was on my way to Worthing Bus Rally at that time. And then it was a period where I was not in. There was a period when I was not in the Covent, in the Covent shop. And then I wasn't next in until about a month later in August. And then I saw the lady. It was the blonde, I would say, the little old blonde. Well, she's not terribly old. I would imagine she's either well into her 60s or early 70s, I would say. And she saw me and said, oh, hello, lovely friend. That's what she... No, it wasn't that. She said, oh, hello, friend. Which says, yes, like, oh, hello there. I said, it's certainly nice seeing you. And then I came in, and then another lady came in, who's, well, younger than the blonde. She looked younger than the blonde. I'd imagine she's either in her 30s or 40s. And then she brought up the COVID subject with me, the lady, the blonde did. And I was like, I understand your point. I said, but I've not planned to go abroad this year. And she said, I think you made a wise choice. And then the young lady did sort of, she only spoke about it very briefly, but did not seem terribly worried. And then she, the lady was just like, yes, well, we've had, yes, yes, and all that. They just said stuff. And I browsed in for a little look. And then this is what I asked the blonde. This is what I asked her after she brought it up to me. I said, did you by any chance get yourself vaccinated against COVID? And then the blonde just said, no. She said, no. And I was like, oh, I was surprised. I was like, oh. I was like, do you have a medical exemption from COVID vaccination? And then there was a very swift, nope. The vaccination program was not very thorough, and I was shocked by what she said. Although she's a very kind and very lovely lady, she was very anti-vax. And I was like, oh, but because she was quite old and not vaccinated, not only was I shocked, I felt quite worried for her. I was like, at your age, and you're not vaccinated. Oh, my. And the young lady, I don't think she had anything against it, but she just wasn't very sure about it. But I think she had her first dose, I think, after I had my second. I'd already had two vaccine doses by that point, months before I had the third booster. And then she asked, and I said, and then the young lady, obviously the older blonde was listening, and the young lady, I said, have you been vaccinated? I was like, I've been, yes, I was like, I have been vaccinated, yes, I've had both vaccines now. But after the lady heard this, the blonde was like, you're too young to be vaccinated. She clearly thought I was too young to be vaccinated. She actually thought, well, she was like, you're too young to be vaccinated. You're only just a boy, aren't you? You're just a boy. You're too young. And I was like, no, I was open. I was like, no, I wasn't too young to be vaccinated. I was perfectly old enough to be vaccinated. And but she was very shocked that I had had the vaccination. She clearly thought I was much too young to be vaxxed. She probably thought I was younger than 18, seeing what I looked like, when many people think I'm many years over that age. No, she's very anti-vax, I have to say, but still a nice lady, and I still very much liked her, but she just had we had varied opinions over the vaccination. And then I respectfully said my goodbyes and then left the coffee shop whilst the other lady, the other customer, stayed in for a while longer. I'm guessing she possibly bought something or just browsed in that time when I went. Then I went again in September of 2021, about 3.5 weeks later, and I bought a nice shirt from the coffee shop. A nice shirt and a nice pair of socks, but it wasn't the old blonde. There was the other lady, who's fairly middle-aged, I would think. Middle-aged, quite stocky, a bit shorter than the blonde. Quite stocky, and she has brown hair, but puts a blonde hair dye above the top. And she's, I would think, with nice sky blue eyes, what she has. Is what she possesses, sorry. And I would think she's probably in her very late 50s, I'd imagine. I saw her again. Said, it's nice to see you again. I said, quite nice to see you. Quite cold, I'm afraid, for September. And she said, cold. She's like, is it cold? It feels really hot to me. as she had a short sleeve shirt on and I had a jacket on. I was wearing my jacket and hat. I was like, all was okay, and I had a nice little conversation with her, and we caught up on things and shared many stuff and all that. And then I went in the next day after going out for a pub Sunday roast and a lunch, and then I saw the old blonde. Then she saw me, and I saw her, looked towards me when I browsed in, and she said, how's life, she was like, how's life been treating you? I was like, oh, life's been treating me extremely well, thank you. But she seemed a bit worried about me when she asked me that question. I don't know whether it's because I'm younger than what she is, but, you know, or whether we've formed a friendship bond, what have you. And then I did go into the Covet shop again in October for a little browsing, and then I shared the story of my late grandfather. It wasn't the old blonde who was in, it was the middle-aged one, with brown hair, quite stocky, as I mentioned before, and with nice sky blue eyes. I shared with her the story of Edmund and the sad story of the ending demise of my late grandfather Edmund. It was the next day after the Spratt and Winkle event in Hastings took place. It was the next day after it took place, in which both David and myself went to. And I spoke to her about my late grandfather Edmund, and that, and because when Spratt and Winkle event took place on what would have been Edmund's birthday, as I did share with David, my friend. And I did share it with the lady. She said, that's nice. She said, but I'm very sorry about your grandfather. But she was surprised when I shared with her the age you only lived to. Because I think she thought I was older than the age I am. I don't think she realised I was just a little 20-year-old at that time. Quite surprisingly. And all that. And then I exchanged my friendly goodbyes, and then, well, she complimented me by saying I looked nice. And then it was about 4 weeks later, I went into Covet again, and I bought some nice things. I bought a Christmas pair of socks for Christmas, and I did buy a gift for David from the Covet shop, which I was really meaning to give to David, but I didn't get to see him for his birthday because I had a gift to give him, which I've still got, which is still ready for me to give to him for when I next see him. But I bought a gift from the Covet shop for my friend David. And it was the old blonde who was in when I bought the gift for David and all that. Just to say. And then I had quite a conversation with the blonde. It was quite a conversation indeed. And it was funny. I even asked her, I was like, did you consider whether you're going to have the vaccination against COVID or not yet? And then she looked towards me, her eyes absolutely widening, and she said, no, it's a no-go to me. I'm not having any vaccination, no flu vaccination, no COVID vaccination, no. Well, it was quite a reaction. I didn't mean to say it to annoy her, but I was only asked it in curiosity. But, you know, she was still happy to have seen me and all that. And when I got the gift, I was like, is the gift for your grandfather? I was like, no, it's not for my grandfather, it's for my friend David. As I did tell him about the Covet shop, just to say, as I said to the old blonde, the pretty little old blonde, and I do know he likes all things heritage, and heritage things like the stuff Covet sell. And she's like, oh, okay, very nice. I said, well, I think And then she said to me, "I think you're very lucky to have a nice friend like David." That's what she said. Well, and not just did the old blonde say that, but also the other lady said that he was very lucky to have a friend like me, you know. Because I went in a few days later for a little browse, and it wasn't the blonde, it was the other lady who was in, who had said before. And it had been quite a while before going in again. And I have been in a few times earlier this year, just to say. And I went in very late January of 2022, and it wasn't the old blonde, and it wasn't the stocky lady. It was another different lady. A lady who has European blood in her, a bit like what I've got. And, oh my goodness. I mean, she was very nice looking, I have to say. Quite old. Well, not as old as... I wouldn't say she's as old as the blonde. She didn't look as old as the blonde, but she could have been, but she didn't look as old as the blonde, but looked older than the stocky lady. She had sort of medium brown hair, but with prominent grey up the very front. A bit shorter than what I am. Very similar body structure to what I have. A slim but reasonably sturdy body structure. Well, the hair wasn't short like mine. It was longer than my hair. And very nice brown eyes. And her face shape was actually fairly comparable to mine, her face shape. But the only difference, her eye colour was a bit different and the nose structure was slightly different. And the hair colour slightly different too. And all that. But the body structure is almost not identical, but very comparable to mine. Very much so. And I was like, the moment I saw her, I was like, oh my goodness, isn't she a lovely looking lady? I was like, well, okay, she's not as pretty as the blonde, but goodness, she's nice looking. But the moment I saw her, because I went and I purchased a cushion again, but the cushion's on my bed. And the cushion, really, it should belong to the royal family, really, in my opinion. And I saw her, and after I purchased the cushion, I struck up a conversation with her. I could not help myself in the slightest. No, really, I could not help myself in the slightest when I struck up a conversation with the lady. And she was very familiar of, she's very, very familiar of the blonde. And this lady had just recovered from a wintry illness in which she said she had was an old-fashioned cold. But obviously she got it quite painfully, I'm afraid. And plus, is a former cancer survivor, this lady. But lovely lady, very nice lady. She didn't sound old. She did sound fairly young, actually, despite looking reasonably old, I must say. She seemed to have a bit more energy than the blonde, in my opinion. Probably not as much energy as the stocky lady, because if you were to talk to the stockier lady, you'd think, goodness, she has pretty high energy levels, despite her structure and for a lady her age. No offence whatsoever. And all that. Very nice. A very nice lady, very familiar of the people I spoke of who I'd seen working in Covet and everything, but really, I very much liked her. I very much liked her. No, really, I did. And, believe it will probably make David quite happy, she is due to attend the Eastbourne Magnificent Motors of 2022. I'm not sure which date she's going on. I know David and myself are going both days. I did tell the lady, actually. And she said she's due to go, but she's not sure whether she's going to go on the 30th of April 2022 or on the 1st of May 2022. She's not fully decided yet. but she is aiming to go herself. And it would be nice to see her there, I must say. And then I went into the Covet shop the next day, and it was the stocky lady. And I said, I was in the previous day, but it wasn't the blonde who was in this time, it was another lady. And she's like, oh yes, she was very familiar of her. And all that. And then I spoke to her, and I was like, but were you aware that she's impressively a cancer survivor? And I said, yes, no, I'd consider her very lucky, in which I would consider her very lucky, because both of us agreed that many people don't survive cancer the first time they get it, but she was lucky enough to have survived it, having had it twice, and completely survived it, you know. And then I went in the next day, and it was again the lovely lady. She's got part German. She has part German ancestral blood in her, the lady. Not the blonde, but the brunette. The older brunette, the lady, with a similar body structure like myself. And I think we do have something in common, the brunette and myself. Both of us have a bit of European blood. And also, we both feel the cold quite a lot, very sadly. I think I'd probably feel it more than her. You know, but she had warmer, probably definitely had warm, thick clothes on. Big trousers, big jumpers. And I obviously was wearing a big jumper at the time when I saw her, but obviously had a big coat over it as well. So that explains we both feel the cold and hot. Although I'd probably feel it more than her, to be honest with her, because she didn't have a big coat on and I did, and plus a big jumper on as well, and winter layers underneath. And it was quite a few weeks, and then I went in again on the 20th of September. No, February 2022, after meeting up with Shahiba at that time. And then I saw a new lady, a new Covet staff member. But this lady, she's in her 60s, she did tell me, because I did tell her about the previous staff I'd seen before, and she said, I'm not familiar of these lovely ladies you've spoken to me of, because I've only just started here. But if I were to meet up with the Covet staff, I would love to meet them, because I did tell her all about the previous Covet staff I'd met. She's not completely taken over from them. I think they just take it in turns in which Covet shop they work in, just to say, as she did say to me. But she had not met the pretty little old blonde or the brunette, or the stocky lady. She'd not met either three of them. But she was like, but after I spoke to her about the three ladies, she was like, I would really quite like to see them for myself, you know. And she's reasonably stocky, this lady, quite short, so little lady. She's shorter than the stocky lady and the brunette and definitely the blonde. But, I mean, and well, she's definitely, well, all four of them are shorter than what I am, just to say. Including the little lady. And I purchased a nice pair of woolen socks, in which I'm wearing today. And then I went in the next day, no, next week, sorry, and it was not the lady, it was a different lady who was half Italian and half German. And she did sound, actually, had an strong Italian accent, this lady. But she doesn't generally work in Covet. She only works there sometimes, as she does hold another occupation as a teacher, this lady. When I saw her, I could not help but strike a conversation with her. But she seemed really, despite having only just first met, she was really happy and she seemed really happy to have met me. when I had a conversation with her and everything, and she spoke to me about that she grew up in Italy and is half German and all that, and that she works in and that she works as a teacher in a nice little art school, and she explained to me the importance of artistry, and in which I completely agreed with her about all of it. I completely agreed with everything she had to say about the true meaning and true importance of artistry. Really? Absolutely, yes. And I purchased a nice pair of socks, and after I did the purchase and had the conversation was over, I exchanged my friendly goodbyes to her, and then I subsequently left the shop. And then I went in the next week, and it was again the lady I saw on the 20th of February, and did tell me, because I did tell her about the lady, and she said, I've not met her either, but I'd probably like to see her too. And this lady, she's incredibly curious. If you were to tell her about these people, she was like, she's the person who is like, if you tell her about one person and what they're like and everything, and depending on how she takes it, she wishes she'd had like their phone number or was in contact with them, and wished, and she was like, and she's just like, if you were to tell her about them and what they're like and everything, she's like, I would just want to see them. She's this lady who would take a big chance in wanting to see someone she doesn't know or is not or is yet to meet, you know. A very highly curious lady and very friendly too. Despite being in her 60s, is what she said to me. I said, I'm quite a way off being my 60s. And she said, I wouldn't have thought you were in your 60s, but I can tell you're a grown man. I mean, she could tell I was a grown man. It was the blonde who thought I was just a boy. But the other ladies, they didn't think I was a boy. They thought I was very much a grown man. All but the blonde. And also the blonde even considered my friend David to be young when I spoke to her about him. And then I purchased a nice pair of socks, and I think that was about it with the COVID woolen sock collection I've got, which is a blue pair I've got, a reddish pair and a green pair, and that's it. And they're useful for the spring and the winter, those ones, I have to say. And spring is not too far from the corner. And then I exchanged my goodbyes to the lady. And she did reveal to me that, like the Italian, she was formerly a teacher as well for well over 20 years. Really, she was. And I was amazed and impressed to have heard the wonderful news. Then we exchanged our friendly goodbyes, and I was like, nice to see you again, hope to see you again, and I respectfully left the shop. And then I went in again, but this time just for a browse, on the 10th of March, 2022, and saw the brunette lady, and she was actually, so she recognized what I looked like despite wearing a different jacket, and she was very happy to see me. She's like, hello. I was like, oh, hello. I recognized what she looked like, and she recognized very much what I looked like and all that, I was like, it's nice seeing you, looking lovely. I could not help but give compliments to her. And she said, oh, well, thank you very much. And I really could not help but say this also. And I said, I have to say, you remind me of myself quite a bit. And then she looked a little puzzled, but was not cross, but looked a little puzzled. And she said, oh. So, why do you say that? I said, well, your face shape is quite similar to mine, And you have really a very comparable body structure to what I have. And we have something in common, as we both feel the cold a lot. And also we've got European ancestral blood in our genetic sequencing. And she was like, oh, okay. And then she very much understood everything I said in referral to it. And she was like, oh, thank you, when I said that she looked lovely. And then I said to, and I gave her in full confirmation that both myself and David were going to the Magnificent Motors event. And she is going to go. And she said she'd probably go with her friend who's located over in Greater London. But said if it was a nice day, she would probably go on her own. But if it was not a nice day, she'd go with her friend. So it was quite funny, really, what she said. She would only go on her own if it was a nice day, but would not go if it was not a nice day. Quite strange. I was like, that's quite strange. But I can understand where you've came from. And all that. And all that funny stuff. And all that. And then after my little observing brows, I exchanged my goodbyes. And actually before, I actually had blown a kiss to her before. But this was back in January. Because I remembered walking past it after I left. I waved to her. I was waving and then I blew a kiss to her. I don't know why I blew a kiss to her, but it just sort of came out from me. But I just liked her very much. I mean, I don't love her, but I like her as a friend, you know, and all that. So, yes. Oh, I'm skipping a time when I went, oh. Yes, I went also on the 5th of February 2022, and I'd pulled a muscle by that point. And I remembered I was shuffling in a bit. Well, I walked in, but I was like, oh, goodness. And then it was the stocky lady who was in, and she said, hello. And she said, is anything all right? I was like, oh, yes. I said, all is okay, but I've pulled a muscle after doing kitty litter. I said, oh, dear. It was a very quick browse, because then I headed off to Seaford after that. I said, well, I've got to go now. I said, just hoping that the back... I'm hoping that the pulled... back muscle strain improves and all the rest of it, but I hope to see you in another time, which is what I said to her. And she said, you have a nice day, and it's nice seeing you looking nice. I said, well, thank you very much. And then I exchanged my goodbyes and then respectfully left and headed off to Seaford. But I know it's very long, this review I've given, but you know, this COVID business is really just a thriving and business of enchantment. It really, really is. And the owner of the COVID business, you know, I mean, it was the Italian who spoke to, I think it's Lynn her name is. It was the Italian who mentioned her to me. And you know, she's a real company girl, this Lynn. She runs an enterprising and thriving business of enchantment, being the COVID business. She has just outdone herself. I have to say, she would certainly be having my service to her business. She will really be having my service to her business. For whenever I go, for whenever I need to get something from there, but you know, she's a real, really good company girl, this Lynn. I've not met her, but she's a real good company girl, I do say, really, she most certainly is. You know, and also, when the twinkle goes out of my eyes for the ladies who work in the COVID business, I'll turn out my toes and die. I loved their friendly hospitality and kind approach in every way. and the covet business, a thriving business of enchantment. And I highly recommend it, as I'd been recommending it to David, but then he inadvertently ended up having a check to their website, because he wanted to see if they had a website first, and then he looked at it and he was like, all the stuff they sell is too big for me, I'm afraid. I think you do find that with more exclusive clothing. Well, he had a point there, he did. But he seemed quite interested in it. Yes. And that's the whole review, really, of the Covet's business in Hove. And, this is not the complete video over yet. There will be something, before the ending of this video. Here's a little something which I think lots of you may like to see. Let's see the last part of the video in action.